Good morning, children. Today we will do report writing. Report writing is quite easy because I'm sure you'll read newspapers every day. So report writing is just like reading an article from a newspaper. There's only one small difference in it, and that is that your name will be given in the report as the student reporter. That's the only difference, okay? Otherwise, I don't know whether you all have, you all read newspapers regularly. You see, when you open your newspaper, you have the heading, correct? So when you see the heading, it's the heading that you analyze and then decide whether you want to go ahead and reading the whole article. So it's like the heading tells you what the article is about, correct? So the heading is really very, very important. It should be such a heading, the heading should be so attractive that a person feels like reading the whole article. Okay, now I'll just read this, then I'll explain further. What is a report? A report is a written account of something that one has observed, heard, done, or investigated. Now, observed, heard, or done means when you have gone and observed a program. Okay, you heard about a program. What you heard about it, that's what you will put in writing. What you seen, you observed in the program, that's what you will put in writing. Now, remember, you are just a reporter observing the program or event or some happening. The happening could be anything, maybe a dance program in some hall, maybe a annual day in a school, maybe an accident that has happened somewhere, a fire that has caught somewhere, someone murdered somewhere. Or investigation could be something that has happened and you are finding out who has done that, like a scam. Okay, so you are going to write all about this. But the main thing to keep in mind is when you are writing all this, remember that you are only and only a reporter observing or investigating from outside. You are not part of the program. You are not part of the event. Clear? So that's why in your report, you are not going to say, supposing even the question is like a dance competition in your school, a Ganpati festival in your vicinity. Vicinity means area. Okay, or in your village, or in your city, or your town. So even though the question says your city, your school, your town, you are not going to say there was a dance program in my school. No, you are only going to mention the name of the school, like there was a dance program in Fatima High School, Badlapur. Clear? Then you are not going to say my principal gave a speech. No. You're going to say the principal gave a speech. Then you're not going to say, and we all went back to our classes when the program ended. No. You will say the students went back to their classes when the program ended. Because you are not part of the program. Remember, you are only an observer. You are only a reporter who is watching the program from out. Clear? So this is the way you have to write. So, because you are only reporting something that has already happened, it is over, it is not happening now anymore, it is not going on. You are reporting something that has already happened. Like an accident has already happened, a program has already happened, okay? So, you are not going to put in your opinion in that, whether you liked the program. No, you are not going to say, I liked the program very much. You will say the program was very well organized. Clear? Or the program was loved by all the spectators. That's the way you will put it. You will not say I liked it or I disliked it. Clear? So a report, very important. Remember these points, because if you put these points, your opinion in it, your ideas in it, or maybe the program should have been like this, they should have done this. No. You are not supposed to say that, because you are only a reporter and you're only reporting. I repeated this three times because in spite of telling, still the children keep on saying, when just because you have written in your vicinity, your school, they write my principal, my school, and we did this and we did that. That's not the way you have to say. The students did, the teachers did, the principal spoke, the children went back to their class. That's the way you have to put it. Clear? Okay. It is a systematic and well-organized presentation of facts and findings of an event that has already taken place somewhere. A report consists of three main parts, mainly the headline, the dateline, and the body. Now, when you have the headline, you're talking of the headline. You also have, along with the headline, the reported by part of it. Comes as part of your headline. Okay, now one thing you have to remember about the headline is I just said it should be catchy so that someone reading the headline wants to read the whole article, because the headline is so interesting. Okay, it makes you curious to want to know what the article is about, want to know more about the incident that happened. That's the way your headline should be put. Yes, now after that you will leave a line. And in the left hand corner, your headline will be in the center. Headline will be in the center. Then leave a line, and in the left hand corner, from the margin, you will write reported by. Reported by. And you will put your name, or you can put the name if in the question a name is given. You are Pia, a student reporter reporting about an accident. Then you will write reported by Pia Chaturvedi. Okay. Otherwise, you will write reported by student reporter is the best. If you don't want to put in your real name, you will just put student reporter. Clear? So the headline also includes the byline, that is the name of the reporter or the student reporter. After that, you leave a line and you start with the date line. Now, what is your date line? Your date line first consists of the place where the event is taking place. Supposing you're talking of an event taking place in Fatima High School, that's in Badlapur. So, the first word you will write over there in your date line is Badlapur. Put a comma. After that, your date, that is say 20th. And which month? Say December. Okay, then 2000 whatever, or if you don't put the year, it's okay. If you don't put the year also, it's okay. You are not going to lose marks for not putting the year, but you really cannot say a board, SSC board keeps on changing the rules 100 times. So just to be on the safer side, now since the 20th century is gone, you can just put 20 and 2 X's. So it means whatever date after the 20th century. Clear? Okay, so you have the date line after that is your Badlapur, 20th December, 20XX, and then you have a colon. You have a colon. That completes your dateline. Now starts your body, and your body is immediately after your dateline, not on the next line. Your body starts immediately after your colon. You start writing your article. Clear? Okay. Now let's read how to write a good report. A report should have a detailed and comprehensive account of an event or incident. The idea must be original and factual, relevant and adequate. That means whatever you are writing about, supposing you are talking about an accident. So you will tell the details of the accident, like where it took place, between whom the accident took place, when it took place, how many were injured, how many died, and how many were maybe serious and how many not so serious. Yes. And where they were taken to the hospital, what action was taken to take care of those who were injured or dead, if there was any compensation given, maybe a local minister came to visit them, maybe at the hospital or at the site of the accident. All this depends on what more you want to write. Clear? Now, this is a detailed and comprehensive. It shouldn't be so much in detail that you tell, if you say 10 are injured and you give each of their names, that's not needed. So you are only supposed to give the relevant details. Clear? Okay. And factual means the actual facts that really happened. No adding your own mirch masala in that. Clear? That's why it said original and factual. Relevant means what is needed, and adequate means the information should be sufficient, not just you said, okay, accident took place, so many people died and so many injured, finish, that's it. Okay, no, you will give the information, what they did to the people who were injured, how they were treated, whether they were treated or no, whether any compensation was given or no. Okay, next, do not include your own viewpoints, personal comments or opinions in the topic. A presentation should be good and effective. It should be written in a proper language. No short forms. You should have no short form, like example, and. If you're going to say and, no writing the short form of and. In fact, this is a rule for anything in English. When you're writing your English paper, you shouldn't use short forms at all. It is seen even in your letter writing, even in your dialogue writing. Children are writing short form and, children are writing yeah, children are writing yay. No, it is yes. So you write yes. Children are writing bro. It's not bro, it's brother. Children are writing sis. It's not sis, it's sister. They write mom, they write dad. You're not supposed to use these such words. If you use such words, out of 4 or 5 marks, you are going to lose one full mark just for using this one word. Even if your whole report or your essay or whatever you are writing is proper. If you have a one-line answer and in between you have written the short form and, you are going to get zero. Or if the teacher is lenient, you may get half a mark. You cannot question because that is a rule. Yes, this is a language. You can do that in science and you can do that in history and you can do that in geography. They will not deduct your marks because that's not language. There they are testing you for your knowledge in that subject. You're being tested for your knowledge in the language, and if you don't know to write a proper AND, you don't deserve the marks. Clear? So it should be interesting so that it captures and holds the attention of the reader. So I just told you, the people should want to read it and read the whole thing, not just read half and then feel bored and then stop. Clear? Now what is the format of a report? I just told you, you have your heading that's in the center, then you have your reported by on the left hand side, and then you leave a line after your heading. Also you will leave a line, then reported by, again leave a line, then you have your place, your date, colon, immediately start with your body. So let's see now what else. Every report is written in 3 main parts, mainly the headline and the byline, the dateline and the body. The headline, it must be catchy, center justified, without any articles and in the present tense. Then the byline, this line contains the name of the reporter and is written at the left hand margin after leaving a line from the headline. If the reporter's name is given in the question, you will write that name, otherwise your own real name. Example, reported by Mangesh Patolian. Or if no name is given, maybe this is the real name, or if no name is given, you just write or reported by student reporter. Next we go to the dateline. The dateline begins with the name of the city, example Badlapur, and the date on which the report is being made, the day you are making the report. Supposing a function is being held today, the date will of your report will be the next day, okay, not after a week. Clear? Example, Thane, 20th December 2000 XX. The body. This may be divided into 3 smaller paragraphs, each containing information in descending order of importance. The opening paragraph, that is the introduction. In the introduction, the introductory paragraph must be the expansion of the headline and as such must contain details of the events being reported. Use questions such as what, when, where, how, why and who. Like you can say, who was invited as the chief guest. You can tell all that. To develop the first paragraph. So in the first paragraph, you will tell when the accident took place, when you talk of an accident, when the accident took place, how it took place, between whom it took place. Okay. In the next, you will tell the details of how many are injured, what did they do with the injured and all. The account of the event in detail, that will be a second para. The proper sequence of events that occurred along with their description. Sequence of events means in the order that it happened. Yes, first you will tell that the accident happened, and then you will tell about the injured, and then you will tell about how many were taken to the hospital, then you will tell how many died. clear? That's the way it should be. Not you'll tell, oh, so many died, and then you'll tell, last you'll tell who. Accident happened between what? Train and a truck. Last. No, that's the wrong way. It is a main paragraph and can be split into two short paragraphs if required. Conclusion. This will include a description of how the event ended. It may include quotes, excerpts from the chief guest's speech, or how the event was wound up. That is, so this will tell you, like, say the program ended with the prize distribution and all the children went back to their own classes. Okay, that will be how your program ended. If you want, you can also say the guest was very impressed by the program or the message of the program, and these are the words that he, and I quote his words, and you will give his exact words. Clear? Okay. So now let's see the model that I've given you. Write a report on World Environment Celebration Day celebration in your school. Now here, see, have I given any name of the report or no? So you can write your own name or just write student report. Answer. Care for the world, grow plants, events. By student reporter. See, I have left space. This is at the center. And this is in the left-hand margin. This is your margin. You are not supposed to leave any space over here. Children have a habit of leaving one finger space here. Some have the habit, they start here and then suddenly they go like this, like as if they are on a slide. Yes, don't do that. Be aware of how you are writing. All your words, the first alphabet and first words in your next line should be near your margin. Okay? Now you have your place, that's Badlapur, then the date, that's 22nd September 20XX, and then your two dots or your colons, you start your main report. In today's society, we cannot turn a blind eye towards pollution. Pollution is the reckoning of today's world, and we are what has caused it to be this way. Reckoning means is the cause of concern. Reason why people are concerned, reason why people are worried, okay? However, we have to band together to stop it. Band together means come together, make a form a group, form a band. That is why Fatima is, a band means not your drum ka band, it's a group, okay? That is why Fatima High School Badlapur decided to organize a Growing Plants Day. That's why I gave the title Growing Plants Event. I just added something more, care for the world. If you want, you can only write growing plant event. Okay, to celebrate Environment Day, the Eco Club of the school was the organizer of the event. The event started with everybody gathering in the garden of the school. Once everybody was seated and comfortable, the speaker came onto the stage and introduced the special guest, Mr. Morey, who is the environmental representative of the ward. He spoke a few wise words and praised the school's efforts in encouraging the planting of trees. Then, there were a few songs for entertainment. In the main event which followed, the Eco Club members demonstrated and explained how we could all be more environmentally friendly and careful. Now, I just told them I didn't tell any details of the program. I can say they did it through a song, they did it through a short skit, they did it through a poem, or whatever way you want to, if you want to expand it further. Everybody was all praise for the students who had put in such a great effort. All vowed to reduce waste on a personal level. Now, this is your main paragraph. At the end, everybody was presented with a potted plant. They were given little pamphlets that told them the species of plants. Now, little pamphlets are little pieces of paper. I'm not sure whether you all are aware. If you'll go towards the station especially, sometimes you find little boys and girls standing over there and distributing little pieces of paper. Yes, in which an advertisement will be there that there's a sale somewhere, or there's a discount somewhere, or there's a class somewhere. If you want to join the class, they're giving you 10% discount for early bird or whatever. So those little papers are called pamphlets. Okay. Now this pamphlet which they got told them the name of the plant, the species of the plant, whether it was a cactus, it was a shrub, it was a herb, whatever, it was a tall tree. Yes. So it was telling them the name and they also gave the plant a personal name so that you could relate. The whoever was planting it would relate to it, because now they were being made aware of the plant, and they were being made responsible to take care of the plant. Maybe when they come to school, they were supposed to water that plant every day. Supposing they named the plant Susie, so they would water little Susie every day till she grew up to be quite big and strong. And even when she grew up to be strong, they would still water Susie, so she would grow up and give them nice beautiful flowers and fruits, right? So that's why they gave it a name. The reason, and a name was also given to the plant so that it had a personal touch. So why did they give it a name? So that you feel that that plant belongs to you, because you have given it life by planting it and you have named it. So it's like a person. Okay, the teachers helped everybody plant the plants into a neat design. Everybody had a lot of fun. This event was a reminder to everyone that taking care of the environment is always for the best, and it is full of excitement and a cause for pride. The day of 21st September was declared as a personal environment day for the school. So which day did this happen? On the 21st of September. And because they had this program on the 21st of September, they decided that every year they will have the environment day on this day in the school. Now see, the report is made on the 22nd. That's because the program happened on the 21st. So the next day the report was made. Let's go to the next model, the second model. Write a report on a book exhibition held in your vicinity. Vicinity means area. See, again they are saying your vicinity, in your school, but nowhere did I say my school, my principal, my teachers. No. Okay. Answer. Books are man's best friends. Reported by Pierre Shah. Here also they have not given any name of the reporter. So I have given any name, or you can just simply write student reporter. Badlapur, 22nd November 20XX. A book exhibition was recently held by the All Maharashtra Book Dealers Association at Katari Hall, Badlapur. The exhibition commenced on November 12th and lasted for 10 days. Commenced means began. The books on display and sale covered all major sections of knowledge and information. It was a thing of interest for children and adults alike. Children were found to be well engaged in their section. Some were seen browsing through storybooks, many hobby books, and quite a few through books of art and crafts. Boys were on the lookout for books on their action heroes like Iron Man, Spider-Man, etc. The computer section was found to be the most visited, with people of all ages making large purchases. So you can add anything more of your own, whatever you feel you can write about on books. In the section showcasing books on food, diet, beauty, lifestyle, clothing, etc., the women folk means the ladies, outnumbered the men, were too engrossed in making their selection and choices. Discounts up to 40% and other attractive schemes were available on the purchases. Now this is the conclusion. Okay, many were reported to have made positive comments on this exhibition. One of them reiterated everyone's thoughts that books are truly man's best friends. Reiterated means confirm again, okay, say it again, make sure that what is said is right. Okay, so now you understood how to write your report. Now let's see the homework that I've given. I'll just read it. Exercise homework. 1. To promote healthy eating habits among students, your school organized nutritious food and snacks competition. The competition was open to both students and parents. The participation was very encouraging. The famous nutrition expert, Dr. Shikha Sharma, was the chief guest. As the student reporter, Swati, write a report on this event in about 100 words. So what is the name of the student reporter? Swati. So you write the student reporter, Swati. You will not write your name or any other name. Clear? Okay. Next. Write a report on an, this is not am, an on accident at an unmanned railway crossing. The unmanned railway crossing means a railway crossing which is always open. There is no one to put down the barrier or lift up the barrier when the train is coming, or to take care that people are not not crossing the railway tracks when a train is about to approach. Clear? So here unmanned means there is no one to do that, no one to stop the people from crossing the tracks. Mentioning the number injured and dead, the hospital they were admitted to, and the compensation announced. So the points that have to be there is how many people were injured and how many were dead, the hospital where they were admitted, and if the compensation, the amount of compensation that was announced. Besides that, other things you can write, but these points have to be there. Clear? Okay, so I hope this is quite easy and you all are able to do it. If you have any doubt, you're stuck anyway, just mention it to me on your message. I will reply and give you the answer and solve your problem. Okay, so thank you. Do have a good day.